What is up, everybody? It is your boy Nick Noodles coming at you with another great video. If you're new to the channel, definitely subscribe and hit the like button if you want to see more content like this. You might as well also follow my Instagram at NickNoodlesYT. I post on there daily, and if you like the channel, you'll definitely like my Instagram. Without further ado, this video is going to be all about Kobe's, and this is inspired by a recent pickup that I have, as well as just all the news surrounding the future of Nike and Kobe shoes. So let's go ahead and talk about my recent pickup, and this right here is the Kobe 6 Protro in the white Del Sol colorway. According to this one website, this was released in 2011. Kobe wore this shoe, and the colorway is supposed to pay homage to the Lakers home jerseys, which I can definitely see with all the different colors, especially with these gold accents. I'm really glad to have another Kobe in my collection. If you didn't know, I actually used to have the Kobe 5 Protro in the DeRozan colorway. However, I got my true to size in that shoe, and it was just way too snug. It literally felt like bunions were gonna start forming on my feet. I tried wearing thin socks. I tried just wearing them unlaced, and they were still just way too snug around my foot, and my toe box was just super, super cramped. So for this shoe, I actually sized half a size up, and honestly, I think I could probably go a full size up. Half size is still a little bit snug, but with thinner socks and the laces untied, it's definitely a lot more comfortable than going true to size. I don't know about other Kobe's, but if you're going to get the Protro 5 or the Protro 6, probably even the Protro 4 because they all kind of have similar shapes, I would definitely go half a size up. If you can get a full size up for cheaper, that'll probably also work as well. So yeah, do not get your true to size in those Kobe models, otherwise your feet will be screaming at you. The next part of the discussion of why I paid resale for these is that this could possibly be the last Kobe shoe that's ever released with Nike. That is crazy to think about, and there's just been so many events that have led up to this moment of Vanessa Bryant not extending the contract with Nike. So let's go ahead and unwrap all of it. So basically in 2016, Kobe signed a 5-year extension with Nike. This would go throughout his retirement. And even though he was retired, because Kobe was such like a great player and so influential in the game of basketball, Nike had no problems extending that contract because they knew that people would still like Kobe's, people would still play in them, and there would still be demand for it. However, after his passing in early 2020, one of the saddest deaths of 2020, probably the saddest death to me, especially right after his retirement, no one saw this coming. No one wanted to believe the news. The effect that this had on Kobe products just shows, you know, his legacy, how much people wanted to appreciate him and own a part of him. The Kobe shoe is like just so influential on the game of basketball and on sneakers as well. I think it's one of the first shoes that kind of modernized low top sneakers. Not many players were wearing low top sneakers before Kobe, I think. A lot of people were wearing the chunky high top ones, and these low top Kobe's kind of showed that you can wear a low top shoe and still ball out every single night. We can definitely see the inspiration on some current players like the Paul George shoe. There is definitely some inspiration from Kobe's on his model. And so I don't blame people wanting Kobe's after his death because they used to just sit in stores. It was really sad. So people just want to pay respect to them. Please don't like hate on people that are just now hopping on the bandwagon, because it was really, really sad. And I think people just want to pay their respects to one of the greatest basketball players of all time. And Kobe releases have just been so difficult to hit ever since his passing. I have taken zero wins on a Kobe for retail. Every single sneakers release I've entered, L. Every single Dick's Sporting Goods waiting line I've entered, L. Every single foot site release has been an L. Even like me trying to bought it, I've taken L because there's just so many people going after it, so many people buying it to resell it. It's impossible to get for retail, in my opinion, at least for most of us. And I could give Nike the benefit of the doubt. At the beginning of last year, they definitely were not prepared for all this demand, and especially with the pandemic starting right around his death, they definitely couldn't have up production. It just was not possible. However, now I feel like there's no excuse for making Kobe super limited other than to drive up artificial hype on your company. People want to play in Kobe's, especially now that they have the modernized technology in the Protro, but they just can't because it doesn't really make sense to spend $300 or $400 resale on a pair of shoes that may last you a season or two. So like Nike is just being really, really greedy at this point, and it just makes no sense. Because of this, Vanessa Bryant has not extended her contract with Nike. It expired in April, I think. And we have no idea what's going to happen. At the beginning of the year, she made a statement saying that anybody that wanted Kobe's would get Kobe's. However, Nike is definitely not holding up that end of the bargain. And I think there is a probability that there will be no more Nike Kobe shoes and that Vanessa Bryant is going to go and do her own thing. I think the breaking point was when the Mambacita pair that was supposed to just be like for her, like a friends and family pair, somehow got backdoored and into the hands of resellers. Now, this is definitely not like Nike's fault as a whole. There was definitely an employee that saw these laying around and definitely just scooped them up and sold them to their friend. The pairs that are out there are definitely probably samples. I highly doubt that Nike was gonna mass produce these. That's just my opinion. I think they got backdoored, but it's still definitely not a good look for Nike at all. And I could definitely see the frustration from Vanessa Bryant because this was not supposed to be released to the public. Like, nobody should really even be wearing these shoes except for the Bryant family. And so I think she's just so tired of Nike, and it's going to take a lot for them to make amends. Like, unless they really start giving the people what they want, you know, these Kobe Protros in mass quantities so that everybody can have a pair, I don't really see them re-signing that contract. And that kind of sucks because if Vanessa Bryant goes and makes her own Kobe shoe, which I know Kobe had kind of been planning, it's still just not going to hit the same, in my opinion, as a Nike Protro. I think there's something special about seeing all these older colorways that he used to wear re-released. It would be cool to see like a new Kobe shoe, but then alongside there were some Nike Protros every now and then. But I feel like if Vanessa Bryant goes and makes her own company, it will give basketball players, you know, the opportunity to wear a new Kobe shoe and actually ball in it for a reasonable price. I kind of want to make an analogy with Jordan. So, like, everybody loves the retro Jordans, like Jordan 1 through 12, I want to say. There's like an infinite amount of demand for those. Like any shoe that releases 1 through 12, it's going to instantly sell out. Some of the newer models, though, like, I don't really care about. No one else really cares about. There is a little bit of hype, and people will actually play in them, but they're not selling out like hotcakes like the 1 through 12 is. So I think there are some GR Nike Kobes that kind of sit on shelves. I think you can get that Kobe, but obviously it's not going to compare to wearing a Kobe Protro, especially in a retro colorway. So this whole situation definitely sucks. Like, it really is a shame that Nike is limiting these products, and I definitely understand Vanessa Bryant's situation and her frustration. However, if she wants to make her own Kobe Bryant shoe that isn't related to Nike, I would be very excited to see what that looks like. However, I will definitely miss out on seeing some of these Kobe Protros coming out. But anyways, that's just my opinion on this whole situation. Let me know what you all think of this. Would you actually buy Kobe shoes that weren't tied to Nike? Would you miss the Protros or would you not? I want to hear everyone's opinion, and I will see you on the next video.